All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ultimate Dirt TV. Tonight, it's the fly-by-night midget series as they come to the longest dirt track we have on the racing.com service. Good evening, Brett Wheeler in the booth along with Stephen McMillan. Stephen, welcome into the Ultimate Dirt TV booth once again. We get set for qualifying, and well, we've got these drivers, these midgets, on this USA International Speedway, 3/4 of a mile in distance. It is, from what seems to be, an absolute eternity for these cars to get around this racetrack tonight.
You're right. I mean, you know, 3/4 of a mile for these little cars. I mean, they're pulling laps. You know, I think the one person pulled a 22.017, but the fastest person on track at practice was Nelson Webster, you know. So, I mean, that's not too bad.
Speaking of Nelson Webster, we are watching the driver in that Tony Stewart Racing Fat Ads Eyewear 19 Designs number 15 car. He has certainly been the pick of the bunch. I do apologize about these, all these notifications coming through. Obviously, the shares are working. So, again, like, shares, and follows. Nelson Webster, we continue to watch the driver in the number 15 car pull it up. 22.279. Brandon Steele in the steelcycle.com entry. Going to roll out onto the racetrack. Keep an eye on some of the other drivers. Trey Smith in that FRM, Front Row Motorsports, car number 12. The man behind the brains behind the FBN Midget Series. Of course, he's done a fantastic and doing an admin's job while racing as well. Steve, you know a little bit about that as well and what it takes to be race control. And of course, you know, trying to keep these drivers in check for tonight.
Oh, yes, definitely. It takes a lot of, you know, you got to have patience on your side when you're trying to do all this admin stuff plus qualified. And it looks like we have tonight 16 drivers that signed up for the fly-by-night midget series. I mean, but it's some good quality drivers. I expect a lot of good racing in this big track. I mean, they should have plenty of room to move around.
Yeah, one thing that we're going away from tonight is there's cautions. We're going to have admin cautions only, so a couple of more cars involved in a wreck. And, of course, no caution laps inside of the last, I believe, 10 to 12 laps. It was that I was told from race control. Trey Smith organizing that one. Trey Smith in car number 12 was third quick, of course. Nelson Webster sits P1. Wade Lamar second quick. Trey Smith third. Trey Burke fourth. And Jarrett Bolliard rounds out your top five. Brandon is still having a tough time as here is the 29, the Indy Race Parts 29 of Harry Stewart, trying to get his first lap in here at this USA International Speedway. It's going to be put him 15th quick with a 23.066.
Hey, you know, you're looking at it, all these drivers have about there's one driver left to qualify with, Brandon Steele. You still have around about a minute and a half left to qualify.
Yes, we do. And Nathan Turner, thank you very much for the follow. I appreciate it. Salama 2, if I pronounce that name wrong, I apologize. Thank you very much for the like on the video. Guys, those likes, shares, all that good stuff. They are, all notifications are working. As we are watching, we're going to be watching Brandon Steele complete his final lap. 22.973. So 0.7 of a second separate positions one, or this entire field, I should say. So, again, 3/4 of a mile in distance. This is a long way around this USA International Speedway. As I said earlier on, Stephen, this is the longest dirt track that we have on the service. And all these drivers are going to gain some speed down the straightaways. And they've got to turn it into these tight little corners. But it is a little bit of a wider racetrack for these midget cars.
It is, and I would say it's probably easier for them to race on this track compared to late models because they got, you know, such a little car and these little tight little turns. You know, when you have a bigger car, it's a little harder on the gas and the brakes. And with these little midget things, they're going to be flying all over.
All right, well, we are just about set to wrap up qualifying. Let's run through first through to 16, as you can see on the left-hand side of your screen. Nelson Webster goes quick time. Wade Lamar, Trey Schmidt, Trey Burke, Jarrett Bolliard, your top five. Brent Hobson, Leighton Kramer, Bryce Kramer, Cody Batten, and Spencer Swofford make up your top 10. Seth Shabesta, Jake Erickson, Harry Stewart, Benjamin Hickman, Tyler Chalk, 15th, and Brandon Steele rounds out the 16-car field. And what I'm assuming are going to be two heat races on the program, two heats of eight cars each.
That's correct, and it's going to be a heavy hitter in heat race number one.
All right, well, let's take a look at your Black Diamond Motorsports starting grid for the opening heat race of the night. And starting on pole of heat race number one, the guy that goes quick time and certainly the man to beat here tonight in car number 15, it's going to be Nelson Webster. On his outside on the front row in car number 12, Trey Schmidt going to line up out of position at number 2. Inside second row out of position 3, car number 97 of Jarrett Bolyard. Out of position 4 in car number 18 will be Leighton Kramer. Starting position number 5 in the 71 car in the FRM Motorsports, it's going to be Cody Batten. On his outside out of position number 6 in caliber 23, Seth Shabesta. And your final row inside, caliber 29 out of position number 7, Harry Stewart. He lines up alongside caliber 93, Tyler Chalk out of position number 8. We've still got Nelson Webster to grid here, Stephen. And well, we've got plenty of time before we let these drivers loose for the opening heat race of the night. I'm going to take away the front row. Who is going to finish higher from third on back?
Well, I'll go with 18 to Leighton Kramer.
All right, okay. I don't want to pick him. I'm not going to pick. You know what? I will pick him. I'm going to pick hashtag Free Cody. I think Free Cody's going to go forward in this one.
Well, I knew you wanted him, so I'll just let you have him, you know.
I don't want him. No one wants him. Let's not free Cody. Let's not free Cody.
Oh, as these midgets head down the back straight away.
Yes, they are lining up in rows of 2x2x2x2 behind YourRacing.com official pace truck. They'll get the 1 degree signal this time by. So the next time by, out of 10 and before, the pace truck will move to the infield and it will be Nelson Webster's race to start. And I dare say that he's going to have a little bit of an early jump. And if Trey Schmidt is going to have anything to say about that one, you know the 12 car is going to be right up alongside him on the exit of turn number 4.
There you go. And you know right now, race control is telling them to rack them and stack them because they're going green next time by. Well, I just can't wait.
Oh, the wait is almost over. Steve, the FBN Midget Series travels to Lakeland, Florida, here at the USA International Speedway in this big 3/4 mile distance. And as I said, the longest dirt track we have on the RRacing.com service. And I'm tell you what, I can't wait for June with hopefully with the release of another track, but also to get the stadium trucks. They are going to be a certainly different kettle of fish. More on that later on. Green flag set to fly off for turn number 4 on the front straightaway, and we are green for the opening heat race of the night. And of course, Nelson Webster and Trey Schmidt going to lead the field down into turn number 1 and 2. Webster up top. Trey Schmidt rolling right down on the bottom side of the racetrack. They're going to go side by side down the back straightaway for the first time. Webster has the advantage momentarily. Can he hold on to it out of turn number 4? We're going to find out. Trey Schmidt continues to work the low side, but Webster's got the run on the top side. Lap number 1 belongs to Nelson Webster.
But you look at Cody Batten in fourth place. He's trying to chase him down. He's looking for the line that's going to make the car move up quicker. And he's putting pressure on the 97 of Jarrett Bolyard.
Bolyard,
I will say this. This is around about one of the roughest tracks we have in iRacing.
Yeah, there's a big ditch hole coming out of turn number 4 as well. That on the top side of the racetrack, if they're on the top, and no doubt some of these drivers might be adventurous in trying to get to the top side, especially on the exit of turn 4 to try and carry that momentum. We might just see that hole come into effect later on tonight. Slider line from Nelson Webster into turn number 3 and 4. Schmidt was right through the middle as well. 3 in the books with 5 laps left to run here in the opening heat race of the night. Just 2 heat races on the program, 2 8-car heat races. As Jarrett Bolyard hanging on to position 3 for the moment. Cody Batten trying every which way possible to try and get around that number 97 in the Pennzoil entry.
You know, he's just following him right behind him in his trails, waiting for him to make a mistake. And he's also sizing them up, see where he can make the move. As you see, as he tries to go to high side into turn one, but he loses a little bit to Jarrett Bouillard. But then he ducks coming out turn two down to the bottom, where Jarrett goes, exits to the... Look at Cody go. He now moves into third place, and Trey Smith comes off turn four off the bottom. Now you got Cody Batten trying to chase down his teammate.
Yeah, Batten moves into position number three, right behind the number 12 car. In fact, there's probably about eight car lengths separating those two drivers right now down the back straight away. That's Cody Batten into position three, Jarrett Bouillard into position four, Tyler Chalk in the 93, the Splash and Go Graphics, number 93 up to position five. Then you go back to the Indy Race Parts, number 29, Harry Stewart in sixth, Leighton Kramer seventh, and Seth Shabesta makes up this eight car field. And well, it's all Nelson Webster out in front. Second is going to be Trey Schmidt as they come to the white flag this time by.
I mean, it's been a long 8 laps. I bet he cannot wait as the white flag will be thrown. But it's some good racing out here. It's not so small where they're all bunched up and, you know, having some contact. With that being said, you look at the rear of the pack, you got a little bit of contact going on back there.
Yep.
But look at Nelson just pulling away from the field.
Yeah, out of turn number four, he will get the checkered flag here in the opening heat race of the night. We take a look at the results. Nelson Webster gets the job done from Trey Smith, Cody Batten, Jarrett Bouillard, Tyler Chalk, Harry Stewart, Leighton Kramer, and Seth Shabesta makes up heat race number one. Heat number two, we're going to move into that in just a few moments' time. Of course, Stephen, I'll let you run down our Black Diamond Motorsports starting grid in just a moment.
All right. All right, on your front row is number two of Wade Lamar. On his outside, be number three of Trey Burke. On the inside of row number two is the 181 of Brett Hobson. On the outside of him, in the number 10 of Bryce Kramer. On your third row inside is number 95 of Spencer Swofford. On the outside of him, be the 114 of Jake Erickson. And your last row is the 51 of Benjamin Hickman, and his outside, Brandon Steele. And you know what? I'll go with Bryce Kramer on this heat race.
All right, good, because I was going to take the front row off you again. I'm going to go Spencer Swofford in the number 95. So I'll see if I can have a driver finish ahead of you again, make it two from two, because like, at the moment, I'm perfect.
You know what? And people watching this broadcast, if you like the broadcast you're seeing, share this. Get your, you know, I mean, we can have some high viewer counts, and it's all because of you. Y'all make this possible every night for Brett to come out here and broadcast these races. So let's show support. Let's get some people on.
Jeff Munch, thank you very much for the follow. Appreciate it, sir. Welcome into Ultimate Dirt TV. And welcome into everybody to Ultimate Dirt TV. We are live on Facebook and Twitch tonight. No YouTube stream working. But the driver's getting the Wonder Green signal behind your iRacing.com official Pace truck. And I can only see seven cars on the racetrack. There is Brandon Steele coming up.
Well, we got one
now.
Yeah, he was lagging a little bit behind, but that's okay as he catches up to the field as they're fixing to rack up and stack up and go green. And I mean, let me tell you, there's some good drivers in this heat race, too. All right, the pace truck will enter into turn number three with the drivers behind them. Pace truck be looking out turn forward, pulling to the infield. He pulls off. Green flags out. Wade Lamar takes the green flag, and Trey Burke was not sleeping on his start. Look at him go. There's three wide at the back. Wade Lamar and Trey Burke can continue to battle. Coming out turn number four, but it's going to be Wade Lamar. Second place is Bryce Kramer, Brett Hobson in fourth place. Fifth place is Spencer Swofford. But you right now, you look at Bryce Kramer, trying to look on the inside of Trey Burke as they go down the back straightaway, single file. And right now, that's what they're doing. They're sizing up the competition, but look at here at Bryce Kramer. Look at the bottom exit, turn number four. But look at Brent Hobson takes over third place from the high side of Bryce Kramer.
Yeah, we got a car upside down. That is going to be the 114 of Jake Erickson. He turns number one and two. We look at the battle on for second and third at the moment. The three car, Trey Burke, holding on to position two. Look at the 181, the Top Gun Motorsports of Brent Hobson. Also trying to make a run at your Trey Burke on the front straight away. And then you go back to Bryce Kramer, holding off Spencer Swofford right now. Bryce Kramer is able to hold off Spencer Swofford, that would put us at 1-for-1 for the evening.
I know, that's right, but you look at going in turn three as Brent Hobson looks underneath of Trey Burke. But Trey Burke will have the momentum coming off the high side. Oh, Brent Hobson gets in the back of Trey Burke and he goes around. That moved Bryce Kramer into third, Brandon Steele to fourth. All Spencer Swofford in sixth right now.
Yeah, he had nowhere to go in that exchange in turn number one and two, so unfortunately for Swofford, he's going to be in sixth spot at the moment. Brent Hobson already back on pit road. He's called the virtual tow truck as we continue to watch the drivers in second and third, Trey Burke and Bryce Kramer, down the back straightaway. Wade Lamar, he is just checked out right now. He is gone.
He is. I mean, and they're completing lap number seven as we speak. As you look at Trey Burke as he entered in turn number one, he hit that little dip there, kind of upset the car. Allow Bryce Kramer to catch up just a little bit, but Trey Burke will pull away on the back.
Wade Lamar comes down the front straightaway. We'll greet the white flag. Out of these drivers of first is into turn number one and two. He now sits two turns away from putting that number two car on the outside of the front row in tonight's dash. Of course, the dash going to be run after this race in the warm-up session. Then, of course, we'll run into tonight's main event. But now to turn a number four and on the front straightaway, it's going to be Wade Lamar getting the job done. Second, going to be Trey Burke. Third, going to go to Bryce Kramer. Benjamin Hickman home in fourth. Brandon Steele rounds out your top five. Spencer Swofford, Jake Erickson, and Brent Hobson. Unfortunately, it did not finish. So we've got heat races early on, Steve, as we move straight into the warm-up session where I believe we're going to be running our dash up next.
All right.
Again, a big thanks to our sponsors here at Ultimate Dirt TV. While we've got the chance to shout these guys out, because without their support, none of this would be possible. A big thanks to Wicked Cushion, 1-9 Designs, World of Thunder, Dirt Leagues Australia, JR Productions and Media, and Black Diamond Motorsports. We get set for the dash here, I believe. We're just waiting on the cars to come out onto the racetrack. And then
So it'll be like Nelson Webster on the front row on the pole. Is that how they were going to do it? How they line up with Wade Lamar?
Yep. It'll be Nelson Webster position one, Wade Lamar position two. I'm trying to think who finished second in heat one. They will start position three. So that'll be Trey Schmidt. Trey Burke out of position four, Cody Batten out of five, and I think was it Brent Hobson who finished, or Bryce Kramer who finished third in that one? Bryce Kramer it was.
Bryce Kramer, yeah.
So wait for those six cars to get onto the racetrack. See, they're on pit road at the moment, just race control, just letting them know what the story is, what's going on. And then, of course, we'll have our dash up next. It's going to be a tough one, but I think Nelson Webster is certainly going to be the man to beat. Again, I'm going to take the front row away from us. Who's going to finish the high out of the rest of the four drivers?
Well, let's see here, because you're going to go with Cody. So I'll go with Trey Burke.
I'm not going Cody. Screw Cody. I had to keep it PG.
Is race control telling base speed of 35? I guess they're going green this time. What do you think?
Who'd you go with?
Trey Burke. Who you go with?
Trey Smith.
All right, Trey's Let's battle out in trays now.
Well, tray's only three, but there's double tray. That's what I did there. There's double tray and double tray laps as well. Six laps. The distance. Green flag is out. Nelson Webster, Wade Lamar on the front row. As they're now going to go side by side for the first time in tonight's dash. Six laps the distance. Burke almost got into the side of Schmidt there into turn number one and two. Keep an eye on Kramer and Batten as well. But it is all Nelson Webster out in front at the moment. Wade Lamar sits second. Trey Schmidt going to go to the top side of the racetrack. Look at Bryce Kramer in the number 10 car working the bottom side of the racetrack.
I mean, you see him going. I mean, it's racy all over track. You see him going to the bottom, to the slider line, exiting up to the high side. Some people are even exiting on the bottom. It's racy still all over this track.
Yeah, it certainly is. Schmidt's now running the slide job line into turn number three and four. Two laps in the books for Nelson Webster. And I dare say that we're not going to have too many problems when it comes to changing up the starting grid for tonight's feature event. Trey Burke again throwing the big Hail Mary into turn number one and two on Trey Schmidt. Schmidt now starting to close in on the back of the number two car down into turn number three and four. He was certainly keeping an eye on where the number two car of Wade Lamar was. Maybe Lamar sort of just kept it down in the middle of the racetrack just a little bit longer than what Trey Schmidt was hoping for.
He did, and white flag just came out, so this is the last lap as they enter in the back straight away. Did you look Trey Schmidt go to the high side? And Trey Burke. And Jacob Flag falls, Brett. And as you see, Nelson Webster wins it. Wade Lamar will be. And then Trey Schmidt. And then Trey Burke.
All right, so 2-1 the score at the moment. Heading into tonight's feature event. What we'll do, we'll take this opportunity to step aside here on Ultimate Dirt TV. We'll come back with your main event in just a few moments' time. And well, let's play a couple of ad breaks.
The most realistic online racing sim ever made. This is iRacing. Detailed laser scan tracks, fully dynamic real world cars, and over 50 series to choose from. 6 online world championships offering over $100,000 in annual prizes. This is the original eSport racing game. This is iRacing.
My name is Stephen Corpenos. I'm a senior web developer here at iRacing, and I work on the beta UI. It's funny because iRacing has been around for 10 years, but we want to keep delivering the best possible user experience to our customers, and we've found that the old UI isn't exactly what we're trying to deliver in 2018. We want to use new features and provide the best possible experience when using the sim. One of the projects that I've been working on is some custom heat racing configuration for hosted races. We've been listening to our customers. Everyone's been asking for custom heat races. Maybe you want to tweak a few things with the preset iRacing configurations. Well, now you can using the beta UI. So once you're at the homepage of the beta UI, you just go to create a race. And from there, you go to your set race options. And you'll notice here under event types, you can actually choose heat racing. First, I'm going to show you how to create a new format from scratch. You can choose the number of entrants. And as you can see, when I made that change, the change was actually reflected on the right side in the graph. Also, you can use the estimated duration at the bottom of the graph when you're changing the length to see what the total duration of your event will be. In addition, you can customize every aspect of the session information, practice, qualifying, heat races, consolations, and of course, the final feature race. Because the beta UI allows us to develop features that are robust and complex, this feature will be exclusively available on the beta UI. Once you've made all of the changes, you can hit save. Say you forgot what you selected. You can always preview it using the preview format button. We are very excited to release the brand new heat racing configuration feature that will be available in season 3 of iRacing.
All right, we are back here on Ultimate Dirt TV for the FBN Midget Series, the fly-by-night Midget Series as they come to USA International Speedway. Brett Wheeler in the booth alongside Stephen McMillan for your call here tonight as we take a look at your Black Diamond Motorsports starting grid for tonight's main event. Starting on pole in caliber 15, that's going to be Nelson Webster. On the outside of the front row in caliber 2, going to be Wade Lamar. Out of position at number 3. In caliber 12, it's going to be Trey Schmidt on his outside. And the number 3 car out of position 4 will be Trey Burke. Out of position 5, the 71 of Cody Batten. Out of position 6, the number 10 car Bryce Kramer. Jared Bolliard in the 97 will start position 7. Out of position 8, the 51 of Benjamin Hickman. Out of position 9, the 93 of Tyler Chalk. Out of position 10, car 5 of Brandon Steele. Harry Stewart in car 29. Out of position 11, Spencer Swafford in the 95. Out of position 12. We go back to Leighton Cromer in car number 18. Out of position 13. Out of position 14. In the 114, it'll be Jake Erickson, Seth Shabesta, and Brent Hobson make up this 16 car field. In fact, make that 15 because Leighton Cromer did not make the grid unless he's coming out late. Well, Steve, again, we are 2-1. I lead the score. Can you even the scoring? Who's going to win other than the front row?
Well, I'll go with Trey Burke again.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what. I'll go with Trey Schmidt again. Those two guys certainly put on a show in the dash, and well, no doubt for 30 laps again, they're going to do the same thing here again. Of course, you're going to see 35 laps on the ticker up on the top left of the screen, but well, consider that we don't have to change anything for the top three rows from the dash finishing positions to where they scheduled or where they were scheduled to start directly from heat race competition. In fact, Leighton Cromer is going to come out off pit road and he will make up this 16 car field. And Steve, as an admin and a league owner, you know what this is all about, and this is one of the greatest sights you will see in all the motorsports.
That's right, iRacing fans and drivers are watching on Ultimate Dirt TV. Show your support as the Fly By Night Midget Series shows their support to you, and thank you for watching them tonight. Four wide, let me tell you, this is the best of the best, can do four wide. Remember that.
Yeah, there's not much to say other than just watch and appreciate these drivers as they get set to do battle 30 laps around the USA International Speedway. And this is one of the best four wide you will ever see. I'm so happy that these drivers are able to get it in four rows of four and just lined up near perfect as they make their way into turn number one and two. The FBN Midget Series drivers are four wide, ladies and gentlemen.
Here we go, and you're watching this one. Know how to get into the Fly By Night Midget Series. Make sure to contact Troy Smith as they now will light up single file. I can tell you they were able to do four wide, and we're still on lap number two.
I wonder if they're going to set them loose just a little bit earlier. I really hope they do. I really hope that we get these extra couple of laps in. Of course, yellows are turned off. It'll be admin cautions or admin called caution. Of course, a couple of cars or more involved. Again, that shakes things up a bit as well, Steve, when it comes to, you know, getting the most green flag laps in, you know, that you possibly can.
It sure does. Everybody's human that races these. I mean, you got some people's mindsets is real thinking, you know, I throw a caution, I catch back up. Well, this just kind of eliminates that and sets a fair playing ground for everyone. And Brett, you know what? There looks like they're bunching them up even tighter now. Like they might go green as time by.
Yeah, well, if that's the case, we are going to have 32 green flag laps scheduled here at the USA International Speedway. The FBN Midget Series main event. This is the calm before the storm, and they are just perfectly poised to take the green flag out of turn number four. It looks like we are going to go green. Of course, we'll have to wait and see what the 15 car does, whether he gets on the gas on the front straight away.
He's on the lap pedal.
Yes, we are green here at USA for the main event. Of course, Nelson Webster. Look at Trey Smith throwing the big slide job on Wade Lamar into turn number one and two. Lamar going to cross back underneath me on the exit of turn number two. Side by side for second and third. They're three and four wide down the back straight away. Into three and four we go, and we're still three wide right now. Look at Batten through the middle. Schmidt on the top side. And Bryce Kramer on the inside. So three team cars, and Trey Burke moves into position number three. Here goes Trey Schmidt back down to the inside. And look at Cody Batten right on the top side, manhandling the cushion in the number 71 car.
Yo, these guys are not scared to put the car where it should belong and still making it possible to end up in the right spot and right place at the right time. I mean, but you look at Trey Burke and Trey Smith. I mean, Trey is going everywhere he can to try to get around Trey Burke. But look at Bryce Kramer in fifth. I mean, they're battling really hard and good right now.
Now Burke down low into turn number three and four. He's going to regain that third spot in turns three and four. Bryce Kramer in the number 10 car, the black and blue, number 10, the FRM. He's doing a great job up into position at number four. Oh, Trey Burke into the wall and upside down. And there goes your pick, and there goes your hopes of picking, making it even two for two. As here he is, the number three upside down. He's on, you'll be calling the virtual tow truck, and we'll take a look at your wicked cushion instant replay.
I mean, that looked like where he just got on the gas, slid to the wall, and you know, this wall ain't gonna move very far.
He won't move at all. I'll tell you, as someone that's tried to knock down this one and two wall and three and four wall many times in a sprint car, I can tell you that it does not move. As we take a look at your Black Diamond Motorsports onboard cameras right now, listen to this thing rev. It is just absolute revving its ring all out. It's limiter bashing as they're getting into the turns, and
it is. You know, go back to that start of the race, as you saw Trey Smith almost battle with Nelson Webster in turn one and two. He knows at the start of the race, at any start of the green flag, you got to go and make your move then, because it's hard to get a car and line, double them back up.
Yeah, it certainly is. He was trying to make the most of a situation. Unfortunately now for Trey Burke with the yellow flag coming out, that is going to end his race, as we're going to go back to
That's right. You know, the pace truck should be turning off its lights this time going to the flag stand. They should be doubling them up. And, you know, you got to think about it. These caution laps are long for these drivers. They're doing around about 40 miles an hour on this three-quarter mile.
I can tell you right now, they go from 23 to 24-second lap times under green flag conditions. You add 30 seconds of caution laps. So these drivers right now, 54, 55-second lap times at the moment while they're rolling around behind this iRacing.com official pace truck, and the lights are off as we are going to have 25 laps left in this main event. And again, that was an admin thrown caution as well, and maybe thinking that, you know, Trey Burke might have been back up on all fours, but unfortunately he was up on the side of the roll cage and, well, called the virtual tow truck. Steve, I'll let you lead us back to the green flag. I got some basketball to finish watching.
All right, as you see Nelson Webster letting pace truck get ahead and pull into the infield. Nelson Webster's on the loud pedal. There goes Wade LaBarre and Bryce Kramer in third. Bryce Kramer looking heavy and deep into Wade LaBarre. Wade LaBarre side by side a little bit. Coming out turn number two. As it's going to be Nelson Webster still going to the lead. But look at here. Bryce Kramer moving up to second place. But Wade LaBarre using the high side with more. Oh, we got one upside down. Flying across the track at the back. Harry Stewart.
Yeah, none other than the wall rider, Harry Stewart. He loves a good piece of the wall, that's for sure. As the yellow flag going to fly, we'll take a look at your Wicked Cushion instant replay. Again, this number 29 car, the Indy Race Parts, number 29. The black and purple entry was working inside on Jarrett Bolyard down the back straight away along with Tyler Chaw. Just caught the inside wall and that was all she wrote. Might not be an outside wall like Harry Stewart's known for, but I mean, still caught a piece of the inside wall and he's going to end up upside down on the virtual tow truck as well.
He is, you know, they're back on these long caution laps. You know, that has to play a mind game with these drivers since caution laps are so long here. You know, I mean, but you've seen Bryce Kramer duck it underneath of Wade LaBarre. I mean, the high side seems to have the advantage right now. That's for sure.
Yeah, I would agree. And again, you know, it's about where these drivers pitch their cars in at a track like USA, because you carry so much speed and, you know, you're really starting to catch, well, some drivers, you know, really starting to catch the rev limiter, you know, like we've seen Trey Burke. We had that, you know, Black Diamond Motorsports onboard camera angles. You can really hear it, you know, banging the limiter going into turn number one and two. And again, they're carrying a lot of speed down these straightaways to then throw it in as hard as they do. I mean, it's a fine art to drive these midget cars, but then you put them on a track like this, it's so long as well. It's just any little mistake, you would think that it's going to certainly end their night very, very quickly, as we've seen, you know, the likes of Trey Burke and Harry Stewart.
And, you know, this track's pretty flat, so, I mean, they don't have, it's hard to rely on a cushion to put, you know, set you up. As you look at the pace truck, with lights are out, they're single file. Nelson Webster, Wade LaBarre, Bryce Kramer, Trey Smith, Cody Batten ran out your top five. You see Nelson Webster letting the pace truck get a little further ahead as for his start. Loud enough field to bunch it up in the back. So far, we've had two cautions. Nelson Webster waiting for a truck to pull into the infield. And he's on the gas. And there goes Wade LaBarre with a good start in second. Bryce Kramer looked like he was sleeping a little bit. Look at Trey Smith go to the high sides. Bryce Kramer goes to the bottom. But look at Wade LaBarre trying to put pressure on Nelson Webster. But he can't do it. Nelson Webster will lead him. And we still got people banging up in the back. Like Leighton Kramer. And it looks like maybe Brent Hobson. But you look at right now, I mean, you see Bryce Kramer trying everything he can do on the bottom. But, I mean, Wade LaBarre just has so much momentum on the high side.
Yeah, yellow flag on the fly. We'll take a look at your Wicked Cushion instant replay. It was the 181 car of Brent Hobson, that Top Gun Motorsports black and red machine. So what happens here, he just threw one and two. In fact, one car got sideways in front of him there, and it might have been the five car of Brandon Steele. It was, in fact, Brandon Steele getting all sorts of out of shape. In fact, there was contact with Tyler Chalk, I believe that was, going into turn number one here at USA. It's just a bit of a racing deal. Steele coming up the racetrack.
And hey, you know, that's one thing with so much speed on this track. I mean, one car spins or loses it. It's hard for someone to slow down.
It really is. Yeah, you really got to limit your mistakes. Otherwise, you know, you have these long yellows. And again, with admin cautions out tonight, you would think that maybe sometimes it's better off just to not throw those admin cautions. Let's try and run, you know, at least 20 green flag laps, and then maybe the final 10 laps have those 10 laps not count towards yellow. I mean, there's a whole bunch of different scenarios that, you know, we could sort of look at, but until iRacing sort of get the laps where the yellow laps don't count towards a total number of laps, I guess, you know, they've just got to make the best of the situation of what we've been given.
That's right, and you see the lights on the pace truck have turned off. That's allowing Nelson Webster, he's going to back off the pace truck a little bit as they enter turns one and two, as everybody else will start to rack them and stack them and starting to form, close up the gaps in the back. I mean, you saw Wade LaMarre get a good jump, and Bryce Kramer was kind of sleeping on that start. Let's see how Wade LaMarre and Bryce Kramer do on this start. As you know, I don't know who could beat Nelson Webster, as he's been really tough the last couple weeks.
It seems just like this FedEx Highway Tony Stewart Racing 19 Designs number 15 car is going to victory lane no matter where we go to in these midget series. Green flag back out onto the racetrack, going to be 16 laps left to run, so we're about the halfway stage of this main event complete. And now remember, the last 10 to 12 laps there will be no yellow flag, so they're just going to run those final 10-12 laps out. Just if you get involved in an accident, well, crap happens. And well, we got some contact as Cody Batten now starting to move backwards through this field. 97 of Jared Bollier as well, he got checked up in that one. And look at Trey Schmidt now all over the back of his teammate Bryce Kramer into one and two. Tyler Chalk and Spencer Swofford side by side battle for fifth and sixth at the moment. But just in front of them, Trey Schmidt again all over the back of Bryce Kramer. Kramer catches the inside wall. Oh, there goes Cody Batten. And Batten is going to go up and around, and yellow is out.
And that's one of those instances where, you know, the cars are going so fast, one person makes a mistake, it's hard for someone to check up right behind you. Especially when you're hitting that wall, inside wall, and it shoots you to the outside. There's no room for someone on the outside of you to slow down to allow you to correct yourself. I mean, this is going to be a wreck.
Yes, unfortunately, it was the Constantina effect. Hello, Robert. Welcome back, buddy. It's been, about a day since I last spoke to you. But yellow flag flies in your main event, and I dare say that might be one of the final times we see the yellow out here tonight, because, well, when the drivers get the green next time, or in a couple of laps' time, I think we're going to have about 10 or 11 laps left to run, and, well, I believe that is going to be the cutoff of a yellow flag. So unless it takes out, you know, at least five or six cars, I don't think we're going to see another yellow after this one.
Yep, and you see some drivers pulling into the pit lane like Cody Batten and some other drivers to get some repairs. They're still under caution. I mean, these are long to caution.
Yeah, like I said, you add 30 seconds on per caution, you know, from what they were doing on time. So, you know, you go from 23 seconds up to, you know, those 50 odd second times, and there's a lot of time to think under yellow here. You know, you really can think about what you're going to do and how you're going to approach it as well. As the drivers are on 2 degree, we'll get the 1 degree signal next time by. That'll leave us with 10 laps left to run.
And you look at your top five, Nelson, Webster, Wade, Lamar. Now in third place is Spencer Swoffer. Fourth is Bryce Kramer. Fifth is Brandon Steele. As you see, Trey Smith in sixth. So he's dropped back to sixth place after the last restart. And it allowed some people like Spencer Swoffer, because the last caution, to move up to third. As you see, the lights go out on your virtual racing pace car. And Nelson Webster will let the pace car get ahead a little bit further as everybody will catch up, bunch them up. Single file restart. This, as you said, Brett, this will be the last restart, hope.
All right, here we go. Drivers down the back straightaway, single file behind your iRacing.com official pace track. They will move to, well, the pace truck will move to the infield on the exit of turn number four. And again, hopefully for the final time, our next two flags are going to be the green. In fact, the next three flags will be green. We'll see a white in nine laps time. And then in 10, we will see the checkered green flag is out.
As you saw, Nelson Webster take him to the bottom on that restart. And Spencer Swoffer just didn't have nothing for him. But you look at Wade Lamar on the high side trying to chase down his teammate. I mean, there's a lot of action in the back, but they're real. Oh, we got one upside down. It's Bryce Kramer flipping on turn number four to the front straight. But as that was the last caution by the admin.
Again, yeah, that's as I said, it was a single car flip anyway, so I'm not surprised that, you know, that, well, I'm not surprised that we're staying green, because as race control did warn the drivers that the final 10 laps are going to be run under the green flag conditions, Nelson Webster, you know, he's going to give him 10 laps out in front to do what he wants to do. How big of a margin can he put between himself and second place runner of Wade Lamar, Spencer Swoffer? Now he's going to move into position three. Fourth is Trey Smith, and Brandon Steele is fifth.
And you had three people get collected in turns one. Katie, but look at this.
Cody Batten went flipping as well. So not a good night for the number 71 machine.
But it's all Nelson Webster, not quick time heat race win. And he looks like he's onto the future race win unless something dramatic happens to him. But you see him as he just trying different lines. He has enough room to practice, you know, basically play around his grooves, because Wade Lamar's run about 10 car lengths behind.
Yeah, you're watching the number two machine of Wade Lamar on the exit of turn number two and down the back straight away. Now you go back to third and fourth. Spencer Swoffer in the black, blue, and white. Number 86, I believe that is, or 88 on the tail tank of that car, but 95 on the ticker. Trey Smith, who holds down position four. Jarrett Bolliard rounds out your top five, and well, the gap is starting to increase for Nelson Webster over Wade Lamar with five laps to go.
But you know, you see them two, even though there's a gap between them, but they have really pulled away between third and fourth. I mean, dramatic. You see Spencer Swoffer, Trey Smith, they're the ones battling for third place right now. Trey Smith tries the slider line, but you see Spencer Swoffer just coming around on the high side.
He put the right rear on the cushion and drove right around the outside. Trey Smith going to dive down low into three and four and catch the wall. That's going to put him around. He gets away from Leighton Kramer. And, well, he's going to get back going again, but unfortunately he's going to be back. Well, he only lost one spot out of that exchange, so it's not too bad for the number 12 car. In fact, he's still going to be in fourth spot as the 18 car is a couple of laps down. And, well, with a couple of laps left to run here in your main event, Nelson Webster now finds himself a mile and a half away from victory lane again. Another win in the midget series.
Trey Smith will pull it into the pits. There's only nine cars on the track. Well, with him in the pits, there's eight left on the. Yeah, I mean, that puts Jarrett Bolliard into fourth, and I guess Brett Hobson will move up to fifth place.
Brett Hobson, I believe, might be on pit row, but we're on the final lap right now, and Nelson Webster, for the final time here at the USA International Speedway, will make his way into turn number three. Out of turn number four, he will see the checkered flags. here at the USA International Speedway, and he just continues his dominating run here in the FBN Midget Series over the past, I'm going to say, month. He has certainly been the man to beat, and he just is getting the job done. We'll take a look at your JR Productions and Media finishing results. Nelson Webster comes away victorious here at USA. Wade Lamar home in second. Spencer Swafford in third. Jarrett Bolyard, fourth. Trey Smith will round out your top five. Leighton Kramer, Bryce Kramer, Brent Hobson, Brandon Steele, and Seth Shebesta. Your top 10, Cody Batten, Benjamin Hickman, Tyler Chalk, Harry Stewart, Trey Burke, and Jake Erickson make up the rest of this field. I think we had 32 laps for tonight's main event. And Steve, it was all Nelson Webster making another dominating drive here in the FBN Midget Series.
He is. I mean, he has been the one to watch all month long, like you said. And it really seems like it doesn't matter what car he's in, sprint cars or the midgets, he's really.
All right, well, let's go down to victory lane and chat with the driver that gets another checkered flag victory here in the Midget Series, and just, again, continuing on his dominating streak here in the Midget Series. Nelson Webster. Nelson, congratulations on the victory, and congratulations on a clean sweep here at USA. Well done, bud.
Oh, thank you, Brett.
Those last 10 laps, we had all green flag runs, and once you got out in front, it was just smooth sailing. It was just a case of hitting your marks and whatnot.
Yeah, the car definitely felt good there. Didn't really know what to expect because we never really run this giant track on the midgets, so I was happy with that. And, you know, it was good to have my teammate behind me. I knew there wouldn't be any crazy stuff going on the restarts, you know, no dive bombs or nothing like that. So kind of comforting there. And, you know, we're just hoping for green laps to kind of put some space on everybody and finish off the race.
Well, it looked like he was on a Sunday drive, Brett. I mean, just watching Nelson, I mean, it was a Sunday drive for him.
Well, what goes through your mind around here under yellow? You know, you talk about, you know, 23, 24-second lap times, you know, under green flag conditions. We had about an extra 30 seconds on those ones. Under yellow, I mean, what do you sort of do to stay focused, you know, considering that, you know, you're doing like 55-second lap times around this big three-quarter of a mile track?
Yeah, it's a long one for sure. It's kind of brutal. So really just chat with people and team speak to kind of pass the time, really.
All right, well, look, well done on the win. And again, you've certainly been the hot shoe in the Midget Series over the past month or so. It's looking like nobody's going to stop you, but again, you keep finding victory lane no matter where we go to, so congratulations on that one. And again, sponsor share, that's all that good stuff. Who makes it happen for you?
Yeah, Drew Neal, 19 Designs, Rico at Fatheads Eyewear, and everyone at TSR, congrats to Wade on the second place. And thanks to you guys for putting this on and doing the awesome
broadcast. All right, there we go. Nelson Webster there home in first place. We'll throw it over to Steve McMillan, who's chatting with Wade Lamar, your second place finisher tonight.
Well, Wade Lamar, congratulations on your second place. Tell me how the track was tonight.
Hey, it was good, especially if you're up front and you weren't caught up in all that mess back there. We got lucky on our starting spot.
Yes, you did. I mean, you know, at the end, you and Nelson were just pulling away from the rest of the field. You know, I want to say I think there was only 8 cars left in the field. But with all these cautions, what's going through your head of how to get a pass?
I didn't really have a plan on getting by Nelson, but I was wishing I didn't take so much fuel, but it didn't seem to hurt either one of us.
Well, who would you like to thank in your sponsors in that tonight?
Well, all of our guys on the TSR team, Drew Neal with 19 Designs, appreciate Trey putting it on for us at Facebook or FBN Midget Series, and you guys for broadcasting.
Well, Wade, we want to thank you for racing with the Fly By Night Midget Series, as you and Nelson put on one hell of a show for everyone.
Well, we appreciate it. Thanks a lot, and we'll catch you guys again.
All right. Back to you, Bert.
Yes, thank you very much. Steve McMillan catching up with Wade Lamar, who comes home in second place here tonight. Stephen, final thoughts from yourself before we wrap things up here from USA.
Well, I mean, it was a good racing up front and even in the back. I mean, long race. There was some cautions that made the race even longer. But other than that, what a great race tonight.
All right, again, Stephen, thank you very much for joining me here in the Ultimate Dirt TV booth. As always, it's been a pleasure to have you alongside me, and you're certainly bringing the energy here to Ultimate Dirt TV once again. So I'm sure we'll work with you again next week, as well. We've got some more stuff to cover throughout the week, and we'll see you back then. But on behalf of the team here at Ultimate Dirt TV, we want to thank our sponsors one more time before we get out of here. You can check them out on our website. Head over to www.ultimatedirttv.com. Of course, click on the sponsors tab, and those wonderful people that help us behind the scenes: Wicked Cushion, 19 Designs, World of Thunder iRacing League, Dirt Leagues Australia, JR Productions and Media, Black Diamond Motorsports, and on behalf of Stephen McMillan and the management behind the scenes, this is Brett Wheeler signing off, saying good night. We will see you Sunday night for the KDC Home Improvement 360 Winged Sprint Car Series and the Ohio Freshwaters Adventures Super Late Models. Good night.